This is the NFL on EA Sports. Two wide receivers will be looking to be number one targets on the field in today's game. It's Cooks' Saints going up against Backlund's Chiefs. The opening kick is straight ahead, so it's time to turn it over to my colleagues, Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis with the call. Gentlemen.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the New Orleans Saints and the Kansas City Chiefs. Hello, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. As we get set here, Charles, we talk about wide receivers. You know, Larry mentioned it in the open. But that's a big spot to look at here in this one.
I think you identified it perfectly because these guys have such an impact on the game nowadays because they throw the ball more than ever. And whether they're throwing it short, medium, or long, can they snatch it out of the air and create even extra yardage with run after catch?
Here's a punter, Thomas Morstead, to get this one started. And we are underway from Arrowhead. On the return, it's Niall Davis. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. But Kansas City and Alex Smith, they didn't go into the bye week as they had hoped. A big loss against Pittsburgh, but a chance to rebound versus Oakland.
And let's face it, they are a resilient bunch. You remember 2015, the horrible start they got off to, and then they ran off that great streak, which led them to the playoffs last year. So I don't think they're too much worried about the one loss. They won't let the effects linger, and Alex Smith will be the one leading them.
Jamal Charles. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. A gain of three, second down. And as we peer at this offense now, let's look at Jamal Charles, a guy who continues to be so productive in this league.
No matter where he touches it on the field, there's a very good chance he could go the distance.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
Four down, four down. Alert. Set. Move 45. Move 45.
Back to throw, Smith. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49.
And there's a completion of Travis Kelce. I think he's starting to come into his own as a tight end and as a player. And that makes his quarterback, Alex Smith, really happy.
So not much to speak of scoring-wise in this first quarter of play. It's a tight game here early. And we're back to Arrowhead after this.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Snickers. You're off your game when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon as the Chiefs in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter. And they've got it here with a first down. Smith, the tight end Kelce has it over the middle. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. A shotgun snap for Smith. toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Smith finding time, going back to Macklin. This time he's got him complete, and he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26 yard line. Give him 7 on the play, and it'll make it a second down. And welcome back. The offensive unit, they took the timeout, and now they get set to line up as we resume action. And slinging it around.
Really confident, too, because they're not trying to fool them with running plays, throwing it, and they're being very successful right now.
Fresh set of downs here. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now a first down throw. It's Smith. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now. He was trying to get it off to Jamal Charles there. And now it's second down.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well, and he didn't get that done on that play.
Smith on second down. He's got time in the pocket. Going underneath for Charles. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. So on third down, the field goal unit will come out as they'll try to get 3 before half. This is an easy one, 23-yarder. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good, and the Chiefs are out to a 3-0 lead. So they kick it through to take the lead. There is a little bit of time left, though, here in the second quarter.
And while they're concerned about not giving up a big return or giving up points themselves going into the half, how good do they feel, though, putting points on the board themselves right near the end of the first half?
After the made field goal, Santos back out there to kick it away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And nice work on the return as he'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game.
Thanks, Brandon. Thanks, Charles. And welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The Chiefs have an edge in time of possession right now. The Saints look like they'll be in this game for four quarters. All right, let's roll those highlights. Chiefs opening the game on offense. Kelsey's going to make the catch in traffic.
And the play will come to an end after a gain of 20.
Chiefs would go on to kick a field goal. So that'll bring our halftime report to a close. We'll go back now to Arrowhead Stadium for the start of the third quarter.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Starts with a run by Ingram. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
The play fake to Ingram. Now it's Breeze. And he is out of bounds, getting it across the 30-yard line. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap, to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. This is Ingram on 1st and 10. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. It'll be a pickup of 4, and it winds us down to the end of the third quarter. We're back now in KC. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point, just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. And they're 6 yards away from picking up the first here on 2nd down. To throw. Backing up. It's brought in here by Willie Snead. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. He'll look to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Jay Howard in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. He's back to throw. And he goes out of bounds, it looks like right at the 50. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll lead here to a third down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you're going to end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. They'll look to throw. And he locates Josh Hill. Complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Back to throw. And he's got it over the middle, Flaner. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. Back to throw, Breeze. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Now here's a defensive timeout called by the Chiefs. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. Out now is the field goal unit for New Orleans. This to potentially send us to overtime. And his kick is right there. It's good. And they will tie this game here in the final seconds. So this hasn't exactly been a battle of one touchdown after another, but at 3-3 now here in the fourth, it's been a pretty doggone entertaining game.
Yeah, it's kind of like a pitcher's duel in baseball, don't you think? The aficionados can appreciate a tightly fought game like this.
Yeah, but the fantasy players, not so much. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. This will be taken in at the one. Oh, he bowls over him. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Well, I have to tell the story. When we were going into overtime, you reached over to my spot charts and you wrote the word tie. Very prophetic. I certainly didn't see this one coming.
You know, there's just something about the way this game played out. I just had a sense and a feeling, and I thought, what the heck? Let's go for it, and let's see what we have. I'm just glad that you remembered that I did that.
You just messed up, though, my beautiful spot charts.
I'll get you new ones, I promise.
Thank you. Nothing between these two teams for four quarters. Here we go to begin overtime. On the return, here's Marcus Murphy. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And now the Saints get set to trot out there. They're set for their first drive here in overtime, and this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day. But I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets double, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far. The drive starts here with a carry by Ingram. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. Second down following the run. First throw of overtime for Breeze. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we ask a lot out of these guys. Block and catch the football, not easily done in today's NFL.
And defensively, it's a nickel formation here on third down and nine. Throwing now is Breeze. So the middle open is Thomas. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
On first and 10, here's Breeze. And Cooks has it over the middle. And he's brought down after a good game. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It'll be their third and final stoppage here in overtime, and we'll be back. And we are back here. I'm Brandon Gaughan alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes a timeout, and now we're set to get going. First down. Over the middle, it's Thomas. And he's brought down. 10 yards on the pickup there. And the Saints are going to get a first down. Well, how about this? The very, very rare tie that we just witnessed. Hard to believe.
You don't see it very often. A bonus period of football, yet both teams go home a little bit unsatisfied.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughan. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports.